Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular, the wireless company that believes in the value of self-expression.
Hi, once again, everyone. I'm Greg Gumbel. Welcome back to our New York studios and to Singular at the Half. Our score at halftime, Duke leading Southern Cal by a score of 43-38. The Trojans hanging with Duke with that athleticism and with the Scalabrine outside jumper.
Well, they made timely three-pointers, but they really hurt Duke by attacking and going inside, outscoring Duke in the paint. Duke has done a nice job defensively and on their board. It's a matter of who's going to make plays in the second half, and you have to lean toward Jason Williams and Shane Battier based on their tournament performance.
Should Duke hold on and move on to the Final Four, it would be only the third time in tournament history two ACC teams would face each other. They would meet up with the Maryland Terrapins. The Terps knocked off Stanford today, 87-73, to earn their very first appearance in the Final Four. Stanford opened the second half with a 7-0 run, capped by Casey Jacobson's three, cut Maryland's lead 42-39.
But a big...
It was frustrating. It was like we were constantly playing out of a hole. And we never got into where, okay, now we're toe-to-toe, it's your basket, our basket. Just never could get there.
So Maryland over Stanford, 87-73. Clark, you called this earlier today. You said that it would probably happen. What was it that Maryland did that made them successful?
Well, they got great play from their bench. Taj Holden had 14 of 22 bench points. They played their game, Greg, and it comes down to that in matchups. Which team can play their game the best? And Maryland did, and they disrupted and confused and frustrated, I think, Stanford by jumping out to that double-digit lead fairly early in the first half.
All right, we're working on our second entry into the Final Four, and we'll find out who else goes tomorrow. Keep this in mind, the road to the Final Four at 2 Eastern time, and then the regional finals doubleheader. Temple against top seed and defending national champ Michigan State in the South Region final. Tip time in Atlanta, 2:40. 5 Eastern, the final piece of the Final Four puzzle. Arizona takes on Illinois in the Midwest Region final in San Antonio. Now, head coach Bill Self led a successful program in
CBS Sports. Exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevy Trucks, Goodyear, the Intel Pentium 4 processor, and by Bud Light.
USC trailing Duke by 5 at the start of the second half. Henry Bibby said his team is allowing Duke to capitalize too much off their turnovers. He said, we have to hold on to the basketball better. As for how they guard Jason Williams in the second half, look for him to double more and force Williams to pass, Jim.
But his team did get back into that game, Billy, late in the first half. What was the difference there?
Well, great play off the bench, which you wouldn't expect. Jarvis Turner coming in, doing a great job offensively. Two big steals on his part. Duke has turned the ball over, Jim, 12 times with only 5 assists. 3 of those turnovers were caused by passers being faked out by the cutters. So Williams picks up 2 turnovers, and it really wasn't his fault.
Dunleavy. Got it. I'll give you another one, though. Williams, after starting 6 of 7 from the field, missed his last 6 in the first half.
Well, it's time for him to slow down a little bit, Jim.
Yeah, you don't expect him to miss 6 in a row.
You know, he made those 19 straight points the other night in the ball game, but you know, earlier this year,
look at him rebound here.
Shane Battier had a run of 20 straight against Georgia Tech.
Duhon 3.
He hasn't been able to hit anything from 3.
You expected Williams certainly to outscore Granville, but production-wise, 16-0 first half.
Well, that one wouldn't bother me. What would bother me if I was SC, if Granville was in foul trouble? He's been able to stay out of foul trouble, and I think can be very important to this team with his leadership.
Picked up one right away, but hasn't had another. Luthen ball. Battier with the position.
Rebounding-wise, also kind of surprising. 18-12, Duke's favor in that first half.
One half of basketball for a ticket to the Final Four. Duhon gets past. No. Clancy slams it back again off the glass this time. His third block.
He got past, but not passed. Clancy is a great shot blocker. Terrific timing. He's got the strength, good leaping ability. Duhon has got to realize if you're going to go ahead and break in there, you've got to finish.
Trepanier up high, and they're the first points of the second half for the Trojans. Williams quickly now. Scalabrine rejects it. Tipped over Granville.
Duke not respecting the shot blocking ability.
Trepanier had the open 3. Steps in, misses the 2.
A nice move on his part, though. upset with himself a little bit, but there's a good, positive, soft shot that he put up there using the glass. Williams is starting to gain some respect, and I think Trepanier is causing him problems with his great athletic ability.
Battier push outside on Clancy. We had a magnificent block earlier.
Well, here's Duhon. He goes in. When you go against this team, don't try to avoid the shot blocker. Take the ball at him. And the same thing with Jason Williams. You've got to take it to his chest.
Robert
great
Hutchins.
Great shot blockers in the past, Jim. They love a guy who tries to avoid the shot block.
Granville out. You see him. And Hutchinson's come in for him. Hero of the Boston College game in the second round. Hit 5 free throws in the last 77 seconds. And Bluthenthal knocks it out of bounds.
Probably should have let that one go and see if Sanders had the hands to pick it up.
Shane Battier having another big game. You know, he, on Selection Sunday, watching with his teammates, he said, I don't know why I said it, but he said, we're going to play USC in the regional final.
Battier again inside, expected a little push. Didn't get it. He was more wide open than he thought.
One of the few people in America would have had that in their brackets, but Battier prophetic.
Just trying to steal some more minutes. Henry Bibby doing a nice job with that bench tonight.
Clancy almost lost it. Holds on too strong.
See Williams normally be able to bust out, but Trepanier
lob
able to stay in with him.
And blocked out of there by Trepanier, USC on the line.
Jim, how many times we've seen Williams when he gets that kind of play, he's just so explosive. But Trepanier is such a great athlete that he can stay with him on that break.
Hutchinson only on the floor for a minute as Granville comes back in. Boozer, his first play of the second half for Sanders.
Boozer, of course, missed all of the ACC tournament, went out in the Maryland game that Duke University lost. They were in the lead when Boozer went out.
Duke hoping to set up a fourth matchup with the Terrapins. Winner takes on Maryland in Minneapolis next Saturday.
Duhon not looking for his shot when it's available.
Dunleavy will go in. Back out. Oh, somehow it squirts to Williams. 4 on the shot clock. Clancy snags it firmly.
Bad possession for Duke University that time, and the reason for it is Duhon does not want to take the outside jumper.
Scalabrini, they've had chances to get it under 5, and Blumenthal will go to the line.
And when he goes to the line, it's almost automatic.
Don't forget, tomorrow, 2 more regional finals. Temple and Michigan State in the South, down in Atlanta. Arizona and Illinois meeting for the 3rd time, this one for the Midwest regional title. So Blumenthal at the line after Williams commits his 2nd.
He was number 10 in the Pac-10 in free throw shooting at right at 80%. Number 1 was Ryan Mendez, 94.7. Tonight he missed a couple, but he made 90 of 95 in the regular season and beat the record that Blumenthal had set earlier in the year in regard to a number of straight free throws. He had 41 in a row. And misses a pair.
Unbelievable.
Upset with himself, shaking his head on the way back down.
Duke at the other end has missed its last 7 shots.
Williams has to feel good now. He's back there with a smaller
Battier.
Pretty good idea by Battier to extend Clancy that far away from the basket.
And Battier reaches in, forces the steal up ahead, Williams. And defended by Scalabrini. Trojans may have the numbers. Nope, 3 devils back.
Good smart hold up.
Scalabrini with a 3.
Yes. Terrific play by Granville. Jim, he almost was tempted to try to take that ball inside. That is the 3rd time Scalabrini has pulled a Battier on Duke by pulling up and taking the outside jumper on the semi-break.
The margin returns to 5. Battier. Tipped over. Blumenthal. USC's had a number of trips. Tried to get it under 5 and failed. Here's another one.
Here's where USC, are they getting a little tired right now with this tremendous amount of energy they put into the start of this second half? Or can they hang right in here?
Blumenthal. Clancy. Powers it in for 2.
And he's not getting tired.
reduced to three. It had been 12 in the first half, the Duke lead.
Now this team, SC, has lost six games to the likes of Arizona and Stanford.
Oh, Williams, timely again.
Even against the matchup that we showed, Duke University, I get a little screen and he'll pull up and take it. But they've lost six games against those outstanding competitors, so they're used to playing this kind of competition.
Williams had missed his last 10 before making that one, a span of almost 18 minutes on the game clock. Clancy and company hanging in there, though. 6-point lead for the Blue Devils.
Honey, where's Otto? Otto? Otto?
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
This is a bucket of water. Goodyear's new AquaTread 3 pumps away over a gallon per second. And with its 80,000-mile tread life limited warranty, that's a lot of water. New AquaTread 3. Only from Goodyear.
Billy, what's the most telling thing you see on this board?
Right here, I think field goal shooting percentage. Duke shot 55%, Jim, in the first half, and SC 47%, so they were on target. Sometimes that stamina, or the lack thereof, will take away your shooting touch. There's a box set by SC. Clancy posting up down low on Boozer. They're wanting to get him the ball.
Scalabrini comes up short and out to Battier. Nate James on the floor for the Devils.
I thought that Scalabrini got hit on the arm on that play. No foul call. He's really working against Battier outside, staying with him.
Duhon has to take it, left open, and the freshman delivers.
That was a huge shot for him to regain some confidence. He wasn't looking for the shot. And Jim, when you rotate the ball and you have a guy that's not looking to shoot, it really hurts your offense. Hedge move by Boozer. He's lost his man.
Lob inside Clancy. He'll head to the line for two. Tuesday on CBS, Barroom Murder Investigation turns into a deadly trap. Don't miss an hour of surprising twists and turns on an all-new Jag Tuesday on CBS. That's Battier's first. And Clancy to the line.
Jim, not a good play that time by Boozer. You don't want to create a big long hedge move like that against a guy who has not made a field goal tonight, as the case of Granville, and allow Clancy then to be left wide open inside. Just a little fake hedge. Let Granville go around and get back on your man.
Clancy asked yesterday what this Elite Eight experience is like. He says, I feel like I'm dreaming. And I'll tell you, I'll share this with you. He said, I had a dream right after the tournament field was announced that we were going to the Final Four. He woke up and told his roommate, Bluthenthal, about that dream.
Well, there you see the 2-3 matchup, trapping down inside. James a little slow with the pass.
Boozer,
no call.
Battier batted around, and Clancy has it.
Boy, Clancy is not only strong and not only has great timing, but he has terrific hands.
Calabrini, pass inside.
Arrow
sills SC. Sanders and Williams come back for Duke.
You see Mike Krzyzewski trying to rest his troops in little short spurts here. SC going with their regular starters a long time. When we start seeing guys bending over and grabbing those pants, which I anticipate will be seen in the next 3 or 4 minutes, you'll know which team is going to go down.
Williams
first.
With the steal. Comes back to him. Unable to finish. And off Trepanier.
Might have been one pass too many. Duhon had the layup. Again, not looking for his shots. You like teamwork and unselfish nature, but you got to take the shot when it's there.
Williams way out there. Bluthenthal up for the board.
Got to question that shot selection there, Jim. I know he's a great player and a great shooter, but that one was really an ill-advised shot.
Scalabrini and Sanders pushed outside. Test your knowledge of tournament trivia and participate in live polls through this interactive telecast available on Ultimate TV. What was it Mike Krzyzewski said yesterday about USC? He says they're tough. I told my team they're men.
And you know, interesting, like Henry Bibby said, we are not a tough basketball team. That is not our personality. That's why I take on the toughness role myself. That's an unusual thing, but an honest thing for a coach to say. Mm-hmm. And here we see that matchup.
Each team shooting 25% in this second half.
Williams will take Scalabrine. No chance.
Wide open. Got right past him.
See, that's why the matchup doesn't really work too well against the Duke, because Jason Williams will get over to the man in the matchup zone area and then just take him one-on-one.
Greeny back of the rim, and Battier has another double-double.
Battier's
fifth game in a row.
Yep, six games with 20 points or more in NCAA tournament play, counting his last game last year. Here again, the matchup for Williams.
Greeny, little his second. It got down to three at one point, but it now is up to 10.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Agilent Technologies, United Airlines, Fidelity Investments, and by Honda.
Jim, here's where the matchup zone gets SC in trouble. The eyes should be on the tummy. Scalabrine is looking at the fake. Watch this. Boom, there goes the shoulder. Uh-oh, where did he go? There is Jason Williams in for the basket.
Driving in for two of his 21.
It's so tough when you get caught in this matchup zone, and Williams is now finding the holes. Battier likes Clancy out there.
Got Clancy to leave his feet. Front of the rim, though. Clancy comes back to retrieve it.
Pretty good defense by Clancy, and then hustling in to get the rebound.
Big moment here for the Trojans. Scalabrine with a three.
He seems he... Oh, and that's
a block called on Scalabrine. USC has gone now 3.5 minutes. What a field goal.
Jim, what's happening to Scalabrine now? He's taken, and remember, he's made a couple of these jumpers, but when he takes that outside jumper, it gives his team no chance to be set for an offensive rebound. So Duke is off and running.
He has three. Clancy has three.
Here comes the trap in the matchup. Tough to trap this guy.
Sanders.
Well, you cannot trap a guard like Jason Williams by running right at him. You got to get him when his back is turned.
Duke ties its biggest lead, 12. Clancy. Off the front of the rim, Trepanier. Packed. He'll shoot a pair.
Here we saw the trap coming right at Jason Williams, but here's a guard that can go and beat double teams. So the only time to trap a man like that is when you can get your single defender to turn his back and then go trap him. And you're looking for trouble to go at him that way.
USC must come back here over the last 11 minutes to complete the dream first relayed to this Trojan contingent by Coach Bibby. When they all arrived on campus in September at their first meeting, he said, we're going to the Final Four, and everyone was kind of stunned. Thereafter, he wore a Final Four hat throughout the rest of the season. He wore it to dinner. He wore it to every practice. And he says, I'm wearing it until we go to the Final Four this year.
Well, he was part of the reason SC's greatest team never got to a Final Four. 71. They only lost two games all year. The two losses, and in those days, only one team from a conference could go to the NCAA tournament. The two losses were to the Bruins and a team that Henry Bibby played on so well.
24-2 they went, but no NCAA for Bob Boyd and the Trojans. Back in those days.
How unfair was that? They might have been the second best team in the country.
Would have been a one seed somewhere, you know? They would have shipped them out. And Dunleavy thought about the three. Nails the two instead.
Yeah, no chance for Hutchinson. And Dunleavy saw that. Liked the matchup, shot right over him.
Of course, they didn't have the seeding process back in those days. That all kicked in some years later. 79. Trepanier.
Boy, they are
over the back. not hitting the shots now.
SC has given up too much from the outside instead of going into Clancy and getting the ball kicked back out. Timeout by Henry Bibby. He's got to say, I don't like what my offense has given me.
10:21 remaining. USC down 12. This is the second piece to the puzzle. Maryland, the first one in and reserved for Minneapolis. It'll be a big week for Mike Krzyzewski, regardless what happens here today. He'll become a grandfather for the second time on Monday. His daughter Debbie and son-in-law Peter Savarino. They'll be inducing labor Monday at Duke Hospital. Their second child on the way. Wish them all the best. Oh, boy. Fancy again.
Normally when Battier beats a big man, that big man cannot recover, but Clancy is just great to watch defensively.
All right, have they settled down offensively? No, Battier had a hand on that one. Trepanier set up the open one, had to hit it.
Nice, good, unselfish play by Clancy to give it up to a teammate instead of the turnaround jump shot.
That breaks a five-minute drought. Down 10, under 10 to play.
Good timeout by Henry Bibby, Jim. Get his team to settle back down and stay within the offense.
Williams gets it back.
Boozer, you can tell that's where being out for six games took away from his coordination a little bit.
Long rebound, Bluthenthal. Williams knows all about 10-point comebacks. Duke was down 10 at College Park with a minute to play, and Williams at one point scored 8 in 14 seconds as they won that first encounter of three. There could be a fourth coming. Bluthenthal. Oh, a three-point shot.
Second time tonight that he's hit a fadeaway jumper from the side. This team does not want to give in. Henry Bibby said they are not a tough team, but they are mentally tough. Again, I think because they played in such an outstanding conference against so many competitive teams, they're not throwing in any towels here. Boozer down inside. He wants the ball. Scalabrini asking for 3 seconds.
Williams hit the shot the other night. Not this time. Clancy secures it with two hands.
If you're Mike Krzyzewski, I think you want to see that ball go down inside. Scalabrini has 3 fouls on him. You get a chance to pick up the fourth as close as this game's being called.
What a good timeout that last one has proven to be by Henry Bibby. 5-0 out of the break. Scalabrini stepped to the hole. Dunleavy knocked it loose. No whistle.
Trepanier's the shot blocker.
Duhon. And he'll go to the line for a pair.
The ball gets blocked here. Right there. A good strip. Actually should have been walking. And then another block. That one by Boozer. And puts Duke off and running. That was a good strip by Dunleavy. And by Boozer.
So the freshman to the line as Duke tries to continue its mastery of the East under Mike Krzyzewski. They are 29-1 when sent to the East bracket. The only team to ever beat a Krzyzewski team in the East was a year ago.
Florida. And after that tremendous game that we had in Winston-Salem, that Kansas played Duke right to the wire.
Overtime.
Yep. Duhon, who's had some big offensive gains, but actually his production, although his minutes are up by 6 in the NCAA tournament, his production is down by 1 point a game.
Luthenthal squares up, hits a big three. Trojans aren't out of it. Jim Nance, Billy Packer, Bonnie Bernstein. You see at the bottom, Michigan State, 9 straight wins, all by double digits. But what about that first note right there, Billy?
Well, we talked about Maryland, the number three. In 1974, we talked about SC in 71, Jim, probably having the second best team in the country, not even getting into the tournament. In 1974, Maryland probably had the third best team behind NC State and UCLA, which eventually met in the semifinals. And they did not get in the NCAA tournament. So finally, the Terps make it. Duke goes to his zone.
Brini in the paint, and it's down to 7.
Duke changed up their defense. Scalabrine took advantage.
It was a classic ACC tournament game that year.
Oh, one of the all-time great ones.
Maryland, NC State.
Maryland could never get over the hump against the Tom Burleson, David Thompson crew.
Both went over 100 that day in an overtime.
Right.
State won. Williams gets free.
Oh,
wow.
That
Clancy
was
couldn't get a handle on that one.
That was mentally a brilliant play. He knew Clancy was going to block him if he went straight up, so he used the rim, shielded Clancy, no chance.
Hutchinson in for Granville. Panier sets him up in the corner. Hutchinson. Clancy slams it down.
When Boozer is not in there to put a body on Clancy, Duke has no chance against his power. See, Duhon doesn't want that shot. He fakes it and doesn't take it. He's got to look positive and want it.
Duke has not turned it over this entire second half. Battier baseline, Sanders.
See, Sanders doesn't want a shot either.
Three on the shot clock. Duhon on the run. Tipped out. Trepanier has it.
He'll go to dunk.
In on Williams. Blocked partially, perhaps. Dunleavy crashed in on him. No whistle.
Duke will have numbers now. Trepanier coming up off the floor.
Williams creates his own numbers. And will they count the basket? Yes, Hutchinson whistled for it.
See, Trepanier was down on the floor in the other end. Williams understood that, so he had the numbers, took advantage of it. And he's a killer. Watch this right here. He knows that Trepanier, who's the shot blocker that he's been worried about all night, is on the floor, so he just goes for the kill. Here he goes inside. Now watch what he does to Clancy. Sorry, fella. I'm going to use the rim, go on the other side. Brilliant play.
Chance for a three-point play. Mike Krzyzewski was saying yesterday, you would be shocked how many players don't love to play. He emphasized love to play. He says Jason Williams just flat loves to play.
Well, I don't think you're going to play for Mike Krzyzewski if you don't love to play. I think it's that simple.
Nate James back.
You can play with less talent and a love to play for him than you can with talent and not a love.
But you know, you and I, we've seen it already in this NCAA tournament. Sometimes players haven't had that attitude like it's win or lose or live or die in this tournament.
Absolutely. For seniors, it's maybe the last time you ever get a chance to play in a team game. There's a guy that loves to play.
Clancy over Boozer.
Boozer just not quick enough, not in condition to play a guy like Clancy.
Clancy has 15.
Dangerous matchup here. Trepanier would like to go for a steal.
Dunleavy looks for some help. Battier inside. James comes in.
That was a great rebound by Nate James. Two hands, weak side help.
CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Turnovers, again, Duke has emphasized that after 12 in the first half, not a one here in the second half. For complete tournament coverage, go to cbs.sportsline.com. And Dunleavy goes to the bench.
How about the subtle substitutions that Mike Krzyzewski is using to get his guys maybe a minute, 2 minutes?
Duhon, the freshman, wanted it that time.
That shot looked very positive.
Blumenthal beats him down the floor. Battier fouls him.
He looks at the referee and smiles. He almost had the piece.
Second on Battier. At the other end, Scalabrine was whistled for his fourth, and he's staying on the floor.
And if you're Duke, one time down, Jim, with 5 minutes to go, as dangerous as Scalabrine is, as a good all-around player as he is, you got to go down inside the low post and see if he can pick up the fifth.
Blumenthal will shoot two. Now, he missed two earlier in this half, which was a shock. The player one time hit 41 in a row. He has long-time family ties with the school, and I mean many generations. Back in the late 1880s, his great-great-great-grandfather, Isaiah Hillman, helped deed the land that the school was built on today at USC. Yet he wanted to go to UCLA his whole life, but his father kept telling him over and over again, you're going to USC. He says he was their biggest recruiter. One of two.
Oh,
back to him, though, Billy.
He got fouled on the arm, and there is Mr. Clancy saying it's all mine.
James will be whistled for that one.
When you don't go up with two hands for rebound here, you're in trouble. Clancy bending over, grabbing those pants. He has played so hard.
First on James. That's the seventh team foul. They've finally got that one all calculated, so it'll be a 1-1 for Clancy.
Went to the line this year 220 times. Shows you how active he is down inside in a league that had a lot of quality big men.
His free throw percentage has improved incrementally all 3 years. Hits the front end of that one. Henry Bibby talked about how it's a real spiritual team yesterday, Billy, you heard him.
Yep.
And he's told his players during the tournament, you have to sacrifice something for each win, because in the coach's words, there's a bigger reward down the road. And I asked some of them, Clancy said, I've given up sweets and video games. They're kind of running out of things. You got one out of two. 9-point game, 5 minutes to play.
I thought Scalabrine giving up some red hair, cranberry juice, and red meat. He's on a tangent there, isn't he? He must not like Stanford.
Well, some thought Stanford would be the next opponent for one of these two at the Final Four, but they were ousted today by Maryland.
Duke starting to go into their spread now. There's that crossover dribble by Jason Williams.
Adia, he would have taken it, couldn't get the handle. Now it's set up for him, the senior, in and out.
Big shot.
Oh, ball loose. James picks up the loose chain.
Boy, give Boozer some credit. He stayed with that. And James, the senior, man that's played technically on 5 ACC championship regular seasons.
That's right.
That'll never be broken.
1 year he got in 6 games, took a medical red shirt. That was another ACC title year. So only man ever. 5 ACC titles, Nate James. Sunday on 60 Minutes. At $250 million over 10 years, Alex Rodriguez has the biggest contract in the history of sports. Is he worth it? You can find out Sunday on 60 Minutes. James out.
Jim, you were giving us a little ancient history on Bluthenhall's great grandfather.
That's right.
I'll tell you something I read about SC in regard to where they are now. They are the largest private employer in Los Angeles. Is that amazing?
Never
that
that.
I would have never guessed it either. 17,000 people are employed by the university.
So Clancy again talked at length to us yesterday. This feels like a dream. He's had that dream of going to the Final Four. They'll need to mount a 10-point comeback to get back even in this game.
There was a fundamentally sound move by Williams there, blocking out the shooter. He gets the rebound instead of Clancy being able to catch it and put it back through. And here's Duke going to their little four corners. They've got really some excellent ball handlers. Dunleavy is hard to handle with the ball defensively. He's got Clancy on him. They ought to let Dunleavy touch it.
Nine on the shot clock, back out. Battier gets his man to commit, steps in.
That's short.
And Granville chases it down. Big possession here for the Trojans. Clancy, Bluthenthal keeps it alive, bangs it home.
Battier misjudged the leap. A lot of times when you go into a delay game like this, unless you can get fouled, you lose some momentum. I think Dunleavy with Bluthenhall is probably the best guy to go ahead and be handling the ball as far as being able to beat his man.
They warned Henry Bibby to get back in the coach's box.
He's out of the coach's box. You sure don't want a technical.
Duhon with a three. Twice now for the freshman.
Isn't that amazing, Jim? He wasn't looking for his shot all game, and he had a positive reaction on both of those jumpers. Fadeaway jumper by Clancy.
You called it. He got it.
Yep, he had that one in his sights for the time he caught the ball.
19 for Clancy.
Yeah, low down.
That's Scalabrine.
Oh, no, they caught it on Trepanier. But Scalabrine was certainly in the area, Billy.
Again, SC does not realize you can't come and trap Williams straight up.
Tonight on CBS, don't miss an all-new episode of Kate Brasher, starring Mary Stuart Masterson, followed by Saturday's number one show, The District. Craig T. Nelson, all here tonight on CBS. That's the seventh team foul, fourth on Trepanier, and a timeout USC. It'll be a 1-1 for Williams when we come out of the break with 2.5 to play and Duke up by 9. Jason Williams and Duke at the line of 1-1. How about a little strategy here for SC?
Well, if you're Henry Bibby, one of the things you know, you have to go ahead and junk the matchup zone. You're going to have to go out and play man-to-man. Scalabrine with 4 fouls. He obviously can't go out and do any pressure whatsoever. That means Granville's probably going to be stuck with Williams most of the time. Williams doesn't mind putting that ball on the floor and going on by. So tough matchup here for SC.
Williams, he had a struggle one time this year at the line.
16 straight free throws Williams missed. Now, you know, I heard the stat, I looked it up, and I still couldn't believe it.
He really struggled mightily, though, at the line in that Carolina loss at Cameron. Certainly it cured those woes. Duke's only missed 1 from the line tonight. We'll be right back. Maryland is heading to Minneapolis and the Final Four to play the winner of this one next Saturday in the national semifinals. 2 more regional finals tomorrow. Not the most conventional route to a college coaching job by Henry Bibby through the minor leagues of the professional ranks, Venezuela, Puerto Rico. An interim stint at USC, Billy. Blumenthal, and he'll go to the line. What's amazing is that Bibby was 0-9 as an interim coach, but Mike Garrett stood by him.
Give Mike Garrett an awful lot of credit in that. Charlie Parker stepped aside, as you said. Henry Bibby became the interim coach. He had worked so hard and so long, unnoticed by many. And going 0-9, a lot of guts by an athletic director to say, you're my man, and he has really delivered.
His first coaching job was about an hour and a half away from here in Amish country in the CBA at Lancaster. The Lightning, player and assistant for Cassie Russell.
Well, he played on 3 NCAA championships at UCLA. 70, 71, and 72 under the legendary coach John Wooden.
Blumenthal, good on both this time.
It's almost amazing to think that he missed 3 free throws in this game.
It really is.
Here's the full court pressure.
Go over the top. Quick turnover.
Big turnover for Duke that had been doing such a good job not turning it over. Mike Krzyzewski calls timeout. He didn't like that at all.
That's the first turnover, Billy, of the half for the doubles. USC ball down 9. Still time. Remember, should it be needed, the arrow belongs to Duke. It's USC ball down 9. That was a big comeback at Oregon, 12 down with 5 minutes to play. SC did at one point this season.
Jim, that was a huge turnover, and I'll tell you why. Had the ball been a good pass, Duke had the numbers for almost an uncontested layup down the other end. Trying to get Blumenthal open for the jumper.
Traveling called on Granville.
Nobody broke, backdoor cut. Again, the turnover will go to the point guard, but the cutters were really at fault.
Picked up his dribble awful quick, too.
Now, watch this. Here will come the trap. Williams with the ball in his hand.
Able to break it rather easily. Under 2 to play.
Duke will use clock. You've got 3 excellent ball handlers on the floor right now. Oh, and Boozer turns his head. Again, the receiver really messes up
Granville,
the point guard.
3-pointer, awfully quick with that one. Didn't lead to anything.
And the fact that he hasn't been an offensive threat tonight probably shouldn't have taken. It's really strange to see so many times tonight that
timeout.
The guys that were the recipient of the pass turned heads or didn't cut properly, and the passer turns it over. See, Boozer turns his head. There it goes.
Duke timeout and possession when we come back. 1:19 remaining, and after that, we'll have only 6 teams still alive in the championship chase. Duke lost only 4 games this year, by a point to Stanford, by 2 in a game against Carolina, by 2 to Virginia, and the biggest loss, 11, to Maryland at Cameron. But they beat him 2 of 3. The two wins, a big comeback at College Park, and a buzzer beater in the ACC tournament. Here's a steal forced by SC.
That really was Williams' own turnover that time, trying to beat the trap before it got to him.
And they get it in the hands of their sharpshooter, Bluthenthal. Granville instead draws the foul.
It's amazing to watch Duke turning this ball over very curiously when they can go ahead and throw it backwards. All they're trying to do here is have that teammate, the clock, work for them.
Duke's turned it over now, Billy. It's last three possessions.
Granville trying to do a lot himself offensively, having been quiet the entire ball game. He did what he was supposed to do in this respect, Jim. He didn't get in any of those cheap fouls that put his team in precarious position.
And even 1 minute to play in Philadelphia for the East regional title. First point for Granville.
You've got to watch Clancy right now if you're Boozer and keep him off the boards and a missed shot. He's ready to sky.
Boozer good
boxes
job. Out.
Good job to block out.
Dunleavy breaks. The bounce pass gets there, but he'll pull it back.
Now you got to think foul in here. If you got to think foul.
Bluthenthal obliges. His second. And it'll be a 1-1 for Dunleavy.
Dunleavy only shooting 69%. As a team, Duke shooting 69%, so he's right on the team average.
Timeout SC. We'll come back with Dunleavy's 1-1. Tonight on CBS, again, Kate Brasher starring Mary Stuart Masterson and Craig T. Nelson, The District. All coming up tonight here on CBS. Dunleavy, the sophomore, Lake Oswego, Oregon, shoot a 1-1. Perfect on that one.
Interesting what Mike Krzyzewski said about Dunleavy yesterday. He said he's growing into his body as a basketball player. He has grown about 3.5 inches since high school and now learning how to be basically a 6'9" guard compared to a second guard as he was recruited to be. Got to get the shot up.
Oh, Bluthenthal just somehow tapped it to Dunleavy. Duhon, he'll wait. Freshman showing some other sage qualities there.
Exactly. You have enough points to win the game. You let your teammates be the clock. They have one more timeout left. Don't use it.
Final 26, 27, 20.7 seconds. And Shane Battier said, I'm not going to be nervous in this tournament. I'm just going to go out and enjoy it. And he's going to have another week to enjoy it.
Mike Krzyzewski, only behind Dean Smith in NCAA tournament wins.
It has been a spirited tournament run by the Trojans. Men of Troy, be proud of their effort. Duhon lays it in. Nope, bounces out. But this one's over. Destination Minneapolis. There'll be an ACC flavor to this year's Final Four. Maryland and Duke.
They love that Greensboro, Philadelphia, Minneapolis roadmap, don't they?
Yep. Just like 92. The Devils follow that track to the Final Four. Back then, it led to a championship. Maryland and Duke. They've had three incredible battles this year. Maryland losing a 10-point lead at home with a minute to play, then winning at Duke, and then the Devils winning in an ACC tournament fight with Nate James Tipman at the buzzer. Chevy MVPs, Clancy of USC, Battier of the Blue Devils. His fourth straight double-double. Duke wins the East again. They're 30-1 all time when playing in this bracket. They're heading to Minneapolis, and we're heading to New York and Greg Gumbel in just a moment.
In the district that's coming up tonight here on CBS. Greg Gumbel and Clark Kellogg in our studios in New York. The Duke Blue Devils move on to the Final Four with a 79-69 win over the University of Southern California. Let's take you back out to Philadelphia and rejoin Jim Nance and Billy Nance and Billy Packer. Jim.
All right. Thank you very much, Greg. And Coach K, congratulations. What was the difference in this game?
Well, they're really tough. I thought Duhon's threes off of Jason's penetration were really momentum savers for us because the game was going in another direction. And our freshmen stepped up big time both times.
And you're going to get to experience the Final Four there, Jason. How about that?
It's great. It's the best feeling in the world. And I've been looking forward to it my whole life.
Shane, I understand your bracket. You had SC as an opponent for tonight's game. Is that on the level?
Well, I've been watching from afar. They're a very good basketball team. And I knew we'd have a battle tonight.
And how about Maryland? It's not like you guys haven't faced them before.
Well, tonight we're just going to enjoy this win. It's not every day you get to go to the Final Four. We're really happy, really excited for us.
It's a great day for the ACC. I'm so happy for Maryland. We've had monumental games against them, and I'm sure the next one will be one like that. But what a great day for our conference because we've had a great, great year in this conference.
Mike, you said you're going to let the guys tear down the nets this year. Yeah. You have experience at this.
Well, I think each team has to celebrate, you know, big things. Winning an Eastern Regional Championship, are you kidding?
One year you didn't, though.
I know, but that was stupid. I must have been had both my hips in my head or whatever.
Well, get ready for the birth of another grandchild.
Yeah, Debbie is home and hope she's feeling well. She's going to have a scheduled C-section on Monday, and that'll make me feel even better than this does.
Good luck to the family on Monday and to the whole Duke family next week in Minneapolis at the Final Four. And let's go back to New York to Greg and Clark.
All right, Jim, thank you. So the Duke Blue Devils qualify for their 13th Final Four, their ninth under Mike Krzyzewski. Earlier tonight, Maryland went to the Final Four for the first time, 87-73 over the Stanford Cardinal. This will mean that Duke and Maryland will play for the fourth time. The first game, January 27th at Maryland, the Terps controlled the first 39 minutes of the game. Jason Williams had 10 turnovers, but in the final minute, he scored 8 points, and the Blue Devils rallied from 10 down to win in overtime, 98-96.
Maryland lost their point guard, Steve Blake, to fouls, and that allowed Duke to apply the pressure and come up with a fabulous comeback.
In game two at Duke on the 27th of February, Shane Battier's final home game. But Maryland was led by Juan Dixon's 28 points. The Terps avenged the loss of a month earlier. Duke not only lost this game, but lost Carlos Boozer to a fractured right foot. Maryland won at 95-81.
Maryland kept the pressure on, played a full court, their comfortable pace game, and got a great game from Juan Dixon.
And in their final meeting, the ACC tournament semifinal, Steve Blake ties the game for Maryland with a three with 8 seconds left. Nate James followed Jason Williams' miss to put Duke up by two. And then Juan Dixon's heave from midcourt was no good, and Duke won this one by two.
This was a terrific game, up and down, lead changes constant, and Duke did a nice job by pushing the ball ahead without using the timeout to get the putback goal.
They will meet again in the Final Four in Minneapolis next weekend. This is what's coming your way tomorrow here on CBS. Begins at noon Eastern time, Papa John's Bumps and Jumps Championship, and then at 1, the Ford Downhill Series. We will see you at 2 o'clock Eastern, the road to the Final Four, then the regional finals doubleheader comes your way. From the South, Temple against the top seed Michigan State, tip time is 2:40. Then we'll go to the Midwest, where number 2 Arizona meets number 1 Illinois, tip time is 5 o'clock Eastern time. The Blue Devils are cutting down the nets in Philadelphia and celebrating yet another Duke Blue Devil trip to the Final Four. Our congratulations to Mike Krzyzewski and to the Duke Blue Devils and to Coach Williams and the Maryland Terrapins from earlier. Final Four bound. Two more teams to be determined tomorrow. For Clark and for everyone here at CBS Sports, I'm Greg Gumbel. We'll see you tomorrow.